Namaste, welcome, and thank you for joining this video series, Great Minds, Great Quotes. These quotes are not simply a collection of words. They are, in fact, the outcome, product, or emergent from deep contemplation. And therefore, to connect with the state of mind of the great men and women, one has to be in deep contemplation to get the true meaning of these quotations. So sincerity, contemplation, commitment to knowledge, and connecting with great minds are the key to understanding, unraveling the full meaning of these quotes. And I have no doubt that these quotes will be of great value to students, teachers, researchers, authors, scholars, public speakers, and leaders. Because no matter what is being said, just adding or sprinkling a few quotations really, really adds to the effectiveness and impact of what you have to say. So I begin with a few quotes today, and we will continue this series for quite some time to come. So today I will pick a few quotations on action or karma and the motivation, intention, and impact of what you do. So the first one is from Buddha. A Buddha is never tired because he is not the doer. What he has, he gives, he overflows. This means that beyond words, what a person speaks reflects his knowledge, his personality. And what he has, what he is, he gives. It is not that he is thinking and trying to impress somebody to say these words. So one should not look at it as just cute sentences, nice words to hear, sounds good. But to stop, freeze your turbulent mind and grasp the meaning. So a Buddha is never tired because he is not the doer. What he does, what he has, he gives, he overflows. This also you might notice here connects you with Bhagavad Gita and the words of Lord Krishna when he says, I am the doer. But you have still the responsibility. Very interesting idea. The next one is, a great man may not do great things. A great man may not do great things, but he does ordinary things greatly. In other words, what you think is a great thing to do, it depends on your opinion, your judgment, your experience. Everybody has their own list of great things to do. But it's not that you choose great things, but whatever you do in a great manner. For example, an artist, no matter what he does, he will do something very artistically. A great musician, no matter what he does, will have a rhythm, a tune, a movement in his activity, which has musical quality. Next one is ability determines what you are capable of doing. Motivation determines what you do. And attitude determines how well you do it. In other words, you may be capable of doing many things. You know a little bit about a lot of things, and you can choose among many actions, many activities. You're capable of doing it, but how well you do depends on how motivated, how sincere, how committed you are to doing this. And your attitude, your approach, your perspective on life will determine how well you do. What you can do, what you will do, and how well you do it. There is a distinction here. Three-way distinction. So it's a beautiful quote. I like it. Ability determines what you are capable of doing. Motivation determines what you do. And attitude determines how well you do it. Now each one, I must say each one of these quotations, if you spend some time with it, contemplate on it, sleep over it, reflect upon it, you will derive the true meaning. It is not like a novel. You read page after page and you say, yeah, that was nice, it's good, and then forget about it. That's not how you will learn from these quotations. This is my humble suggestion, because I have learned that way from these quotations over the last 30 or 40 years. Another one is, and if you gaze for long into an abyss, the abyss gazes also into you. There was deep space, great vacuum. If you gaze into it, you may not find any material object, but what you will find is an expanse of emptiness, of deep subconscious, upconscious knowledge, and it responds to your attention by sharing, by instilling the same deep knowledge into you. So I find this to be beautiful. This is by Friedrich Nietzsche. And if you gaze for long into an abyss, the abyss also gazes into you. A couple of more for today is this one. This is from an unknown author, folk wisdom. Do something for someone who will never be able to repay you. In other words, if your gifts, if your giving is only material objects that can be repaid. If you give money, somebody can repay you, conceivably. But if you give your love, your affection, your sense of service, your sharing, your empathy, that has no monetary value in terms of any object or money. So, it cannot be repaid. It can only be repaid in kind. So, remember this. Do something for someone who will never be able to repay you. This one is by Nisargadatt Maharaj, a great mystic. He has many disciples around the world, and I have met many of them. Nisargadatt Maharaj, His famous book, I Am That, has wonderful quotations and teachings. Do what you believe in and believe what you do. All else is waste of energy and time. In other words, don't do things out of compulsion, out of, oh, I don't really want to do it, but I have to do it, I have to do something. So what you believe in, when you do it, you will do a better job. You'll do with dedication, it will produce the better result than you can expect. So do what you believe in and believe what you do. All else is waste of energy and time. And this one is from Theodore Roosevelt. Do what you can with what you have, where you are. In other words, your capability can change over time. What you can do is not constant. You can do same things all the time. You can do maybe better things, different things. Where you are in that position, in that situation, in that context, in that environment, your environment also has an effect on what you can do or what opportunities are for you. So take advantage of your environment, what you know, what you have, and do your best. This is the message of this quotation. Do what you can with what you have, where you are. Thank you for listening. I'm so happy to share these quotations with you. And we'll meet again in the very near future. So this is my favorite subject, and I'll be sharing many more quotations over the next few months or maybe years, as long as possible.